So today we are reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, 9th canto, chapter 15, text 25. The name of this chapter is Parshuram, the Lord's Warrior Incarnations. Savairatnam tu tadrishtva Atmasvaryati sayanam Tannadriyat agnihotryam Sabhilasa sahayaya Saha He Kartavirayana Why Indeed Ratnam A great source of wealth. Tu, indeed. Tat, the Kamadhenu in the possession of Jamadagni. Drishtva, by observing. Atma Aishwarya, his own personal opulence. Atisayanam, which was exceeding. Tat, that, na, not, adriyata, appreciated very much. Agnihatryam, in that cow, which was useful for executing the Agnihatra sacrifice. Sa abhilasaha, became desirous. Sa haya haya. With his own man, the Hayahat. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami, Srila Prabhupada. Translation. Kartavirjayana thought that Jamadagni was more powerful and wealthy than himself because of possessing a jewel in the form of Kamadhenu. Therefore, he and his own men, the Hayas, were not very much appreciative of Jamadagni's reception. On the contrary, they wanted to possess that Kamadhenu, which was useful for the execution of the Agnihotra sacrifice. Purport. Jamadagni was more powerful than Kartavirayana because of performing the Agnihotra Yajna with clarified butter received from the Kamadhenu. Not everyone can be expected to possess such a cow. Nonetheless, an ordinary man may possess an ordinary cow, give protection to this animal, take sufficient milk from it and engage the milk to produce butter and clarified ghee, especially for performing the Agnihotra Yajna. This is possible for everyone. Thus, we find that in Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna advises Goraksha, the protection of cows. This is essential because if cows are cared for properly, they will surely supply sufficient milk. We have practical experience in America that in our various ISKCON farms, we are giving proper protection to the cows and receiving more than enough milk. In other farms, the cows do not deliver as much milk as in our farms. Because our cows know very well that we are not going to kill them. They are happy and they give ample milk. Therefore, this instruction given by Lord Krishna on Goraksha is extremely meaningful. The whole world must learn from Krishna how to live happily without scarcity simply by producing food grains, annat bhavanti bhutani, and giving protection to the cows, Goraksha. Krishi Goraksha Vanijam Vaishakarma Svabhavajam. Those who belong to the third level of human society, namely the mercantile people, must keep land for producing food grains and giving protection to cows. This is the injunction of Bhagavad Gita. In the matter of protecting the cows, the meat eaters will protest. But in answer to them, we may say that since Krishna gives stress to cow protection, those who are inclined to eat meat may eat the flesh of unimportant animals like hogs, dogs, goats and sheep. But they should not touch the life of the cows, for this is destructive to the spiritual advancement of human society. Savai ratnam tutadrushtva atmaiswaryati sayanam tan nadriyat agnihutyam sabhilasa sahaya. So here in this verse of Srimad Bhagavatam, the activity of Kartavirajam with his followers is described. As we are hearing since few days about Kartavirajuna, how he was very powerful king and he was benedicted by the great sage Dattatreya. As a result, pride came in his mind or in his heart. Pride developed. Because when someone becomes very powerful, opulent, then naturally the pride will develop within him. As it has been stated in Srimad Bhagavatam, Janma Aishwarya Sruta Sri Edhamana Madhapuman. When someone takes birth in a high aristocratic family, when one gets material opulence, and when one becomes very beautiful, or one becomes very learned by studying different scriptures, then pride develops within one's heart. And specifically, it has been stated by Srila Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur that the pride arising from Janma, Shruta and Sri means high aristocratic birth, from great learning and beauty. This pride is not so dangerous as it is dangerous which arises from material opulence. When someone becomes materially very opulent, very wealthy, he becomes so much proud that he loses his intelligence. And as a result, he commits offense at the lotus feet of great personalities. So here we see that Kartavirajuna was materially very opulent, very powerful. As a result, we have heard that he even stopped the flow of the river Narmada by his 1,000 hands. He was so powerful. So naturally, the pride developed in him. And when he came to the ashram of the sage Jamadagni, while he was hunting in the forest with his followers, so he came to the ashram of Jamadagni, and Jamadagni also was a very powerful sage. And he had a Kamadhenu, which was very convenient to get whatever one likes. Because Kamadhenu, whatever one desires, one can get from that cow, Kamadhenu cow. Generally, the cows, they give milk. They cannot give anything else. But Kamadhenu can give whatever one likes. Whatever one wants, Kamadhenu can supply. Not only milk. That's why it is called Kamadhenu. So when the king arrived in Jamadagni's ashram with his entourage, naturally there are so many people with the king, his soldiers, his ministers, his officers, his advisors, so many people were there. And the sage who is living in the forest, generally the sages, they live in the forest, they sustain themselves from fruits and roots. But when the king is arriving in the ashram with his entourage, with so many people, then Jamadagni, because he had this cow, Kamadhenu cow, so he got everything, whatever he desired, to receive the king very nicely in an opulent way. So when the king, Kartavirjuna, was received by Jamadagni very opulently, then he thought that this sage living in the forest, so how did he get all these items to receive us in a very opulent way? Then he found out this Kamadhenu was residing in the ashram of Jamadagni. And Jamadagni was getting all these ingredients from Kamadhenu to receive the king with all opulence. So he became envious. Because of this pride, envy developed. He said, this sage, he is not supposed to be so opulent with this Kamadhenu. I am the king, I am the emperor of the whole world. So I should possess this car. Because I am traveling with so many soldiers and I need this cow to feed my soldiers opulently wherever I go. What the sage will do with this cow? That's why he wanted to get that Kamadhenu from Jamadagni. So here it is described, Savilas. So he desired to get this Kamadhenu from Jamadagni. And when Jamadagni was asked for this, Jamadagni refused. He said, because of this cow, I am able to perform Agnihotra sacrifice. Because this Agnihotra sacrifice, actually it is mentioned that every grihastha must perform this sacrifice every day at home. And as it says, Jamadagni, he was also performing this Agnihotra sacrifice in his ashram every day. And to perform sacrifice, purified butter or ghee is necessary. And the ghee must be very pure, coming from the cow, Nowadays the ghee we get in the market is not very pure. Because in those days, people in general, they used to keep cows in their homes. In every home, one can find at least one cow, maybe more than that. That's how people in those days, they were always getting enough milk, enough ghee, enough cheese, everything they were getting. There is no scarcity of milk. Even I have heard in our childhood days that the cows' udder would be so full that when the cows would, after grazing in the forest, they would just lie down or sleep under a tree. So that time milk would come out from their udder automatically and moisten the earth. So sufficient grazing ground was there, and it has been also recorded in the revenue maps in India, gochara. The land is dedicated only for the cows. There would be grass in that land and the cows would come and graze. There's specific land mentioned for cows. Nowadays the gochara land is taken away by the builders and others. Now the cows have no place to go and graze. So in those days people, they would keep cows in their home, and a person in the village would take all the cows of all the people to the forest, go in the morning and bring the cows back in the evening. So there is no expenditure actually for the cows. Nowadays if you have to keep a cow, you have to purchase so many things. So this culture, Vedic culture, was so nice and so simple and so healthy that people would keep cows, get pure milk, ghee, cheese, everything. So their health was taken care of by this. And then they would have land and they would produce so many different kinds of food grains from the land, which was produced by cow dung only. So the economy was actually self-sufficient. The cow dung would come from the cows, that would go to the field, and the bulls would cultivate the fields, and there was no need of any fertilizer or any chemical. From cow dung, the earth would produce so many nice foodstuffs. So in this way, people were getting pure food. Nowadays we get all adulterated food, all chemicals, fertilizers. That's why we are getting sick. In those days, I have seen 90 years old person even does not use a speck. His eyesight was used to be very strong. They would not fall sick. There was no hospitals anyway. So there was not any major sickness. Nowadays everywhere we go, diabetes, cancer, major things are now coronavirus. Killing. So because of our artificial living, we are actually creating inconvenience for ourselves in the name of advancement. People in those days were dependent on krishi, goraksha, and banijya. Commercial activity was also based on barter system. No money was required. If someone has to buy something, he can give some food grains, and instead of food grain he can get whatever he desired. Even the workers would work in the field, and at the end of the day they would come back and take some food grains for their work. No money. So this system was there, and it was so nice. People were not dependent on cities. The village people would stay in their own village, and they can get all necessities of life in their own village. The other people, like weavers, they will weave clothes. There would be barber in every village, so no need to go to saloon. So everything was taken care of. That's why Vedic culture was so rich and so healthy, peaceful. People were so peaceful. Nowadays we have given up this Vedic culture. That's why we have invited miseries, material miseries, or man-made miseries, we can say. We have created miseries for ourselves by giving up this Vedic culture. That's why Prabhupada is stressing here in purport that how cow protection is very important. And he gives the example of our ISKCON farms, that how cows in ISKCON farms are giving more milk than the farms outside. Because cows are feeling protected in ISKCON farms. And elsewhere, they are always in a great anxiety that at any moment they would be killed. And when the cow is in anxiety, it will restrict its milk. That's how we see, when we go to milk a cow, we take the calf and put the calf, first let the calf drink some milk from the udder of the calf. Why do we do this? Just to inspire the cow, because the cow would feel affection for the calf. When the calf would go and drink milk from the udder of the cow would feel affection for the calf and start giving milk. Then what we do? After some time we take out the calf, we take out milk ourselves. So we have to inspire the cow to give milk. But if cow is not inspired, it is in anxiety, it will restrict giving milk. And nowadays we are creating artificial pregnancy in cows, and without calf also we are trying to milk. So this is, that milk is not actually very healthy. So this Vedic culture is so glorious and so much needed for human civilization. Because when we take pure milk, then our finer tissues of the brain would develop very nicely. So we can understand the higher goal of life. Or we can understand the intricacies of devotional service. We can understand the glories of the Supreme Lord when our tissues in the brain are developed nicely. But nowadays people, they don't take even cow's milk, they take buffalo milk. That's a the finer tissues are blocked. They cannot take interest in spiritual life. They cannot understand Krishna consciousness. That's why they are not interested. So anyway, here we see Kartavirajana. He is very desirous of taking this Kamadhenu from the ashram of Jamadagni. And Jamadagni, when refused, then Kartavirya Arjuna used his royal power because he was king and he was very powerful. Even he defeated Ravana, we know. So he was very powerful. He said, who cares for the sage? We must take this cow. That's why he ordered his followers to forcibly take away Kamdhenu from the ashram of Jamadagni. So when this thing happened, that Kartavirjarjuna, because he was very proud of his opulence, he did not care for the sage or sage sentiment, and he forcibly took away the cow. Though Kartavirjarjuna was also very religious, pious person, he was also performing sacrifices. He was also giving charity. He was doing all these things. But how this material opulence is bewildering him, we can see from his action. That how he became very proud because of his material opulence and lost his intelligence and committed offense at the lotus feet of Jamadagni. And we know from Srimad Bhagavatam that Ayushriya Yasodharma Lokanang Asisayevacha Hanti Shriyansi Sarvani Punsa Mahat Atikram. And when a person offends a great personality, then what happens to him? Immediately his ayu, means the duration of life, is reduced. His opulence is reduced, Shriya. His glories are also reduced to nil. Instead of being glorified, he is blasphemed. And his religious piety, that is also destroyed. By offending a great personality, this thing happens. So we see later on that because Kartavirjarjuna offended Jamadagni, and later on we see that Jamadagni's youngest son, Lord Parshuram, when he heard that Kartavirjarjuna has stolen Kamadhenu from his father's hermitage, he went with his bow and arrow and his fierce axe to fight with Kartavirjarjuna. And Kartavirjarjuna was very powerful king. When he heard that Parshurama has come, he sent 17 Akshuhini soldiers to fight with one person, Parshuram. And Parshuram single-handedly killed all the soldiers, not a single person went back. And then Kartavirjarjuna came and he had 1,000 hands. So in 1,000 hands he had 500 bows and arrows. Simultaneously he was releasing the arrows towards Parshuram. But Parshuram, by his one arrow, he cut all the arrows of Kartavirjarjuna and cut his hands and then cut his head. So this is the result of offending a great personality. That immediately he lost everything. Kartavirjarjuna, he lost everything. He lost his life, he lost his glories, he lost his opulence, everything. That's why one has to be very careful while dealing with great personalities. And as it has been stated, that how pride arising from opulence is very, very dangerous. more dangerous than the pride arising from other things. It can take away everything in man's possession, even his own life. So here we see that Karta Viryajana, not only he offended Jamadagni by forcibly taking away his cow, Kamadhenu, he also, as a great king, he misutilized his power. Because when someone is very powerful and the power is coming from Krishna only, Krishna gives intelligence, he gives power, he gives everything, wealth, everything. So Krishna is the source of power. And the kings, those who are powerful kings, they are supposed to use their power to protect religious principles. That is the proper utilization of king's power. But here we see that Kartavirajana misutilized his power by taking away forcibly Jamadagni's cow, Kamadhenu, and offending him. And in this way, actually he did not do the duty of a religious pious king. The king is supposed to protect citizens, and specifically, the king is supposed to protect the sages, the brahmanas, the vaishnavas, because they are the wealth, real wealth of the king, real wealth of the kingdom. When there are great personalities, great sages, great brahmanas, vaishnavas are present in a kingdom, the king has all opportunity to seek their advice in different administrative matters. Because the king is supposed to follow the instruction of the Supreme Lord. The king actually represents the Supreme Lord in this earthly planet. That's why the kings are called Bhumidev. They are the lords in the earth because they are representative of the Supreme Lord. So they are supposed to protect religious principles, and to protect religious principles they are supposed to use their power. The king's power is not meant to offend the sages, Vaishnavas or Brahmanas. Or the king's power is not meant to punish the sages, Brahmins and Vaishnavas. The king is meant to take advice from them and rule the kingdom in a religious way, and where people can all become happy in his kingdom. So here we see Kartavirajana, though he was a great king, actually he was born in Yadu dynasty. And he was so powerful that his name was actually Arjuna. Kartavirya was added because he was the son of Kritavirya. That's why he is called Kartavirya Arjuna. And according to his name, the Pandava Arjuna's name was given. Because he was a great personality, so Arjuna's name was also given accordingly. So he was coming in a great dynasty in which Krishna also appeared. in Yadu dynasty. But because of this act, he acted irreligiously. That's why he lost everything. He lost his life because of this. So he utilized his powers and offended a great sage. So in this way, we can learn from this that how pride arising from opulence destroys everything. That's why opulence is nice. Everyone wants opulence in life, but one has to be very careful not to be proud enough to offend the great personalities. That's why Krishna says that those who have received wealth, those who have received knowledge, those who are beautiful, and those who have taken birth in a high aristocratic family, after getting all these opulences, if someone is not proud, one is very humble, even after getting all these things, which make a person proud. But Krishna says, if someone is not proud after getting all these opulences, then one should understand that he has received my mercy. That means those who are devotees of Krishna, even if they attain all these opulences, they never become proud of that. They always remain humble in their heart and utilize their opulences in the service of Krishna. That is actually the goal of life. That whatever we have got by Krishna's mercy, we should utilize that in Krishna's service. Then our life will become successful. But when we receive mercy, receive opulence from Krishna and try to enjoy ourselves, then we become thief. That we are receiving from Krishna, but we are not offering to him. We are trying to enjoy ourselves. Then we become a thief and subject to punishment by the laws of nature. That's why we have to be very careful by hearing the pastimes of Kartavirjarjuna, that how he lost everything because of offending a great personality, as he became very envious, proud of his opulence, and in this way destroyed his reputation. So we'll stop here. Hare Krishna. Is there any comments or questions?
Yes.
For example, in our day-to-day life, if we possess something nice and somebody asks out of envy, that please give it to me. So what should we do?
Yes.
Give it or should we refuse it?
This is a very nice question. That Jamadagni refused because he was getting the ingredients to perform this Agnihotra sacrifice. Because this cow was in his possession, so he was getting whatever was needed for performing Agnihotra sacrifice. That's why he refused, that if he would give out the cow, then he would not get everything. to perform his own religious principles. But when Kartavirya Arjuna forcibly took away the cow and Parshuram went and killed him, and when Parshuram came back to Jamadagni, because when Parshuram heard this thing that Kartavirya Arjuna had stolen the cow of his father, he immediately was very angry and immediately went to kill Kartavirya Arjuna. But after killing, when he came back to the ashram and offered his obeisances to Jamadagni, then Jamadagni instructed Parshuram. And he said that, "My dear boy, what you did, you should have not done this. For this small thing or for small offense, we cannot kill the king who is maintaining the whole world, maintaining the citizens. He made a mistake, that's true. But for that mistake, we cannot kill him. Instead, we would have tolerated his offense." Jamadagni told Parshuram that we would have tolerated his offense. And in this way, actually we would have saved the king to rule the world. And then he said that we are Brahmins. Jamadagni said, "We are Brahmins, and Brahmins' duty is to tolerate." So this is the nature of Brahmins. Brahmins cannot become angry. Sama dama tapa saucha kshanti arjamaye vacha jnana vijnana astikyam brahma karma svabhava. So Jamadagni said, "We are Brahmins, so our nature should be tolerant. So we cannot become angry and go and kill the king because he made this offense to us or stole away our cow." Though Jamadagni did not want to give, but even when it was stolen away, still he did not become revengeful. He acted like a Brahmin. He was tolerant. But Lord Parshuram came to teach the Kshatriyas, because Kshatriyas were going out of their way, not following the religious principles. That's why Lord Parshuram came for that purpose, to teach the Kshatriyas and kill those who are impious. That's why he did that. But Jamadagni acted as a Brahmin says and instructed Parshuram in that way. So tolerance is the wealth of Brahmins and Vaishnavas. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also teaches the same thing. Trinandapi suni chayana taravarapi sahishma amani namanadena kirtaniya sadahari. So sahishnu na. The devotees are supposed to be sahishnu, tolerant and humble, and don't desire any respect from others, but ready to give respect to others, thinking that Krishna is residing in everyone's heart. Okay? Hare Krishna. Jai Granthraj Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai. Jai Srila Prabhupada ji Maharaj ki. Jai Sisi Gaurnitai ki. Jai Sisi Krishna Balaram ki. Jai Sisi Radha Sam Sundaral Tapisagadevi ki. Jai Samaveta Bhakta Vrinda ki. Nitai Gaur Primanande Hari.